A lower proportion of young offenders are completing their probation orders. 10% fewer among them finished their programs last year compared with 2018. Authorities say it's partly down to the profile of offenders. Higher-risk youth are often the ones given the court-mandated probation compared to those deemed lower risk who may take on community rehab programs. Li Liying with this report.
As a child growing up, Aaron was alone most of the time. He joined a gang at 11 and got into serious trouble at 15. He trashed a coffee shop with his friends and was handed a 2-year probation order. The terms included obeying curfew and attending school regularly, but he often skipped classes because he felt ostracized.
They looked at me and they saw like someone that just is hopeless, is pointless. And sometimes they will even try to avoid me. There's also time restriction. Sometimes you're out there seeing your fun, your friends having fun and partying and stuff, and you're just locked at home. I thought to myself, like, is there a way that I can stick out? But maybe it's just one time, two times. Later, I let on to more times.
Many of Aaron's peers who are on probation also have issues adjusting. Some end up not completing the orders. According to statistics, the completion rate for probation orders issued to those under 16 was 64% last year, compared to 73% in 2018. Authorities say this is partly due to youths with minor offences undergoing rehabilitation in the community. Younger offenders also tend to be more impulsive.
Since 2018, we have the integrated service providers, whereby we divert the cases, the cases away from our criminal justice system. And so our probation officers deal with higher risk cases. Youths are actually, they are at a developmental stage whereby their cognitive functioning is not fully developed as yet. They deal with also maybe some family circumstances.
Those who continue to break the rules during probation might be given more restrictions, like staying in a hostel, where they are monitored more closely and only allowed to return home on weekends. 54% of youths who stayed at a hostel completed probation, compared to 72% who didn't. This is partly because youths admitted into hostels already face more complex challenges. The Singapore Boys Hostel says the experience could be a turning point for some of them.
How does staying in a hostel help them?
Some boys really do struggle, but we've also met some boys who thrive with structure because maybe they've lived for a long time without having any routines or supervision. We've seen boys who, you know, they don't go to school for very long periods of time, and suddenly now they're in hostel and they're going to school regularly. They're attending classes, they are doing well.
As for Aaron, his probation ends in October. He's 17 now and is no longer the kid he used to be.
From the kid that felt no love, all of a sudden there was a group of people that was there for me, and I really appreciate that.